Hello and welcome back to another episode of the Digital Health and Wearables series. Today I have another magnificent guest and leader for you. But before I go ahead, let me remind you to subscribe and share the amazing content with your communities in healthcare, and also acknowledge our partners, the digital health platform CliniTouch V, and our industry partner, Isaac Care. And today gives me great pleasure to introduce you to Susanne Baars. She's a senior global thought leader at Siemens-Healthineers. She's also the CEO and founder at SocialGenomics and a TED speaker. Susanne, how are you?
Yay, thank you. Thank you so much for inviting me and to be here. And so great to see you again.
Thanks for accepting the invite. We're talking before the show that you're busy with lots of different things, projects, events, and thank you for making the time. And finally, we are recording, which I'm very pleased about.
Same here. And I love the topic. If we talk about the future of precision medicine, you know, my big dream for the world is that we make personalized treatments accessible for every person. So I'd love to talk.
Fantastic. So introducing the topic, precision medicine and the future of cancer care. I'm going to go to the first question. Okay, Susanne?
Yes.
So the first question is, what's the real potential of precision medicine?
Yeah, that's an excellent question. Well, the real potential, let me first start with what is precision medicine and where does it stand for? I believe it's really in the broadest sense about how can we democratize access to personalized healthcare for everyone. So that means giving access to the right treatment that's needed, but also when it's needed, where it's needed. So this whole topic, it ranges from how can we give the right personalized precision treatments to how can we redesign our healthcare systems to also make really sure that those patients have access to the care that they need. So talking about this and the potential, it's all about precision and personalization. In this future, we don't have a one-size-fits-all approach anymore to patients. We know that every human is unique, and so is our makeup, both our genomics and how we go through life and the changes and how it affects our state and our body on a physical level. So it's really about being able to use that information to find out what is really important. And the three levels, dimensions that matters most in the future, it's about early detection. How can we detect diseases earlier, in an earlier stage, using precision medicine, by using diagnostics, by using data, because if we're early, we can still treat them and they're not so complex. The secondly is the highly personalization. So how can we use the data from a person to really personalize the treatment, both the treatment choice, but also the treatment delivery method, the time frame? We know that patients respond differently to medications. So how can we time that and adjust that? And the third one is highly localized. So how can we also use information about a patient to really target the disease area, so that if you have cancer, for example, with radiotherapy, that you can really contour the tumor, and not only where the tumor cells are, but now in the future, even use specific markers about specific cells to adjust doses and the radiation itself. And these are just a few examples, and I know we have limited time, so we can talk more about that. But maybe to add as a last point to this, if we talk about the big transformative power behind this, it's also really about shifting the stage from late diagnosis to early diagnosis. It's about distinguishing the healthcare system from standardized care and complex care to see, like, okay, how can we optimize the pathways, the care pathways, accordingly in our systems to realize this precision medicine in practice, and also about the treatment delivery methods.
Brilliant. Susanne, thank you so much for that amazing overview and explanation. And now we nowadays, as you know, healthcare go through a big transformation. We talk about big data, we talk about genomics, we talk about DNA sequences, so many things, wearables. So precision medicine really has an enormous potential. So thank you so much. And a nice follow-up question for you is, do you have any groundbreaking examples to share with us?
Yes, that's another excellent question. And why? Because we're living in such an exciting time. I mean, a lot in the world is happening, of course, also that makes us very thoughtful. But in the same time, we're facing a transformation with science. So the amount of precision medicine treatments that are entering the market is enormously. We're also in the midst of the transformation of digitalization. And I believe with precision medicine, it's where those two worlds come together, where you use the molecular data points from a person together with the technology, so AI, machine learning, to then really make sense and direct and make it precise. To give a few examples, what we see a lot is we used to diagnose a cancer patient, for example, you have breast cancer, you have lung cancer, and then in hospitals there are protocols that are usually 6 years old and behind in science. But what we now do is we have a better collaboration with the academia and science, so that someone comes in the hospital, you already give access to precision diagnostics, so to really look into what is this tumor from this patient, and then being able, based on the results, to then use artificial intelligence and software to look, okay, what, based on data from similar patients, is the best treatment with the highest chance to survive. I believe this is a breakthrough because it means we can stop treating patients with treatments that don't work. And currently, in the old way, that applies to the majority of patients. I think last week there was a study. Something else that I find very fascinating is artificial intelligence drug discovery. So how can you use the markers on a molecular level to then run a study through the data to find a marker and then design a personalized treatment on demand for some people? And I know maybe even a lot of people, this sounds like very futuristic, but now there are some companies like in silico medicine in the world that are now having more and more proof cases. So also last week there was everywhere in the news about rectal cancer that they screened with a marker and that they're now in a clinical study and that they saw that the entire tumor disappeared. Can you believe that?
No.
Yeah. And another, just to mention one more thing, and this is on another level, is how do you optimize your hospital, your care systems? Now, for example, in radiology, what you can do through AI and automation, you can really transform a process that usually takes 2 months to give a patient access from the point of diagnosis to access to the radiotherapy, transformed it into 2 weeks, into 2 hours. So what does that mean? That does not only mean that a patient can get treatment immediately on the same day. It also means, if you look to the innovative treatment delivery methods, that you as a hospital become super agile, have the flexibility to adjust according to those personalized treatment plans.
Well, that's fantastic. You mentioned so much in there. I mean, of course, the personalized focus and treatment, and also cancer now. I mean, the chances are much higher of long-term treatment and longer-term life. But you mentioned the rectal treatment of cancer. I'm actually interviewing someone next week. I can't reveal. But someone in the US from Cleveland, a clinic, and we're talking about that subject. So very interesting. But you mentioned radiology and that shortening the process with the methodologies, the technology.
Yes.
Truly groundbreaking. Things are progressing so fast that is actually very difficult, even for a guy like me that is in the industry every day, to keep up with everything, because things are actually moving really, really fast. Thank you so much, Susanne.
Yes.
The third and last question that I have for you is, what is your prediction in terms of curing most cancers with precision medicine or other innovations?
Yeah. Now, the exciting part here is as well, like, why is cancer such a big killer? That's because currently most patients are diagnosed in a late stage. So when you're in a late stage, it's complex. When it's complex, it's usually already not curable anymore. But now, usually cancer also takes a runway of 10 years. So if we're early, it is just a few dividing cells that look differently. So we're able to cure them. So if we shift from late stage to early stage with early detection, we can make cancer in some cases, or hopefully many cases, make them curable. So it's a matter of time frame. Another thing, of course, is that we will be better. So we get new combinations of immunotherapy and targeted treatments so that we can hopefully make cancer more a chronic disease. So it's not directly deadly because we're able, through the restorative power of the body, to live with it and to create a moat in that. Of course, there are also other diseases. So also if you, for example, consider rare diseases, one in 15 people will be diagnosed with a rare disease throughout their life. It's a huge part of the population. But usually it's only one change in the DNA that's causing that disease. And we now already see with CRISPR-Cas, for example, and gene therapies, that you can even replace that faulty gene and that you can then live a disease-free life. So there's a lot to do. And of course, this might sound easier than it is, because in reality, of course, it's super complex because we build a super complex healthcare system. But this is something about the potential of precision medicine. So maybe to end this question also with a serious note, apart from everything that is possible, I believe it's up to us to take the responsibility as healthcare professionals and people from the industry to really think about how can we redesign the system and what can we do to give more patients access? Because we are facing a world where half of the world's population does not have access to quality care at all. But even here in the most advanced healthcare systems, we see a big problem that if these strategies are not applied, patients still don't get access to the treatment that they need. So patient empowerment, and for us as professionals, the responsibility to work super hard on that, I believe.
Brilliant. Thank you, Susanne. I mean, thank you for mentioning that. And I'm very passionate about creating impact in humanity and disseminate this content and talk about different things. Unfortunately, I experienced a family member dying from a throat cancer back in 2003. He was very, very young. He was only 52, and it was exactly what you described, a very late stage detection that he had two operations and it was not possible to save him. So, yeah, and also you mentioned that even in the most advanced care systems that we live in I'm in UK, you are in the Netherlands, even sometimes we experience that or the treatment is not appropriate or the detection for one reason or another is still later stage. But we're saving a lot of lives, but of course we can do more. And I'm very keen about raising this awareness, you know, because we're all human beings. At the end of the day, you might be 25, you might be 85, but these affect us all.
Thank you for sharing that. And you know, that's collaboration, right? We're now, that's also the future. Future of precision medicine is also made through collaboration.
Yeah. And Susanne, you know, you hear all these things, the slogans in the industry, data is the new oil, is the new currency. But I learned something with someone else. Collaboration is the new currency.
Exactly.
And I truly believe that. And you just remind me of that. Anyway, Susanne, we could talk for hours, as you know. I come to the end of the episode. I appreciate your time, your expertise, the amazing, amazing insights. I finish all my episodes in a peculiar way, which is not a question as such. It's called 1 minute of fame. And you can mention anything, your work at Siemens, your personal life, a shout out to family. I mean, anything whatsoever, a company, anything whatsoever. Over to you to round up 1 minute of fame.
Yeah, thank you so much. Yeah, for everyone, hi from everywhere in the world. So I started a moonshot 6 years ago, and that is to give personalized, make personalized treatments accessible for every person on the planet. With my team, we start to help and guide individual patients who are currently searching. So a part where we just mentioned of all the potential that's there to really help and guide those who are diagnosed and are now facing this big silos of, okay, what can I do and where to go? So for the 1 minute of fame, I would just say that if you listen to this and you recognize this situation, or this is something also that makes your heart beat a little bit faster, please reach out to me and I would love to get in contact and see how we can stand for this mission as one team. Brilliant. And shape the future together.
Brilliant. Susanne, thank you so much. Thank you so thank much you. For being in here once again. I'm going to round up now. To all our viewers and listeners, make sure you follow Susanne. Ask her questions. She's a true global leader and professional. I'm going to put a link to connect with Susanne on LinkedIn and on social media. Make sure you engage and connect with her. And to round up, make sure you subscribe to the channel and acknowledge our partners, the digital health platform CliniTouch V, and our industry partner, Isaac Care. And I'll see you all next week.